People used to consume alcohol every day and night and was part of their lives. Consumption of alcohol was so rampant that people would drink alcohol even during the battle. Then one fine day, they hear an announcement that alcohol is prohibited. After listening to the announcement, people started spitting, vomiting and throwing alcohol on the streets. This is not a scene from a movie, but something which the world witnessed 1400 years ago under the leadership of Prophet Muhammad. One of the biggest evils at the time of Prophet Muhammad was the consumption of alcohol. The Prophet termed alcohol as mother of all evils. During the time of the Prophet, alcohol was prohibited in stages. In the first stage, a strong foundation was laid where the people were told to believe in the one true God and follow his commands, which were revealed to Prophet Muhammad, and told that they would be accountable about their deeds on the day of judgment. In the second stage, the negative aspects of alcohol were highlighted, where the Quran said that there are more disadvantages than advantages in the consumption of alcohol. In the third stage, the people were asked not to perform prayer when they are under the influence of alcohol. In the last and final stage, people were completely prohibited to consume alcohol, and it was stated that the evil act is from Satan and one needs to keep away from it if they want to be successful. And the Satan always wants to cause animosity and hatred through intoxicants and prevent people from the remembrance of Allah and from prayer. After this revelation, no person ever dared to drink even a drop of alcohol, and alcohol was poured into the streets of Medina. Everyone followed the laws wholeheartedly, as they knew that it was for their own good. On the other hand, for decades, many people blamed alcohol for almost all human misery and misfortune. So USA tried to ban alcohol from 1920 to 1933. The initiative was known as the Noble Experiment. As a result of the prohibition, large-scale alcohol producers were shut down and individual citizens started producing alcohol illegally at their homes, and the entire family would be involved in the production. People also started manufacturing and purchasing alcohol in secret, and it opened a whole new black market for alcohol. Organized smuggling of alcohol from Canada and elsewhere also developed quickly. Murders and hijacking became common in this dangerous but lucrative business. As the prohibition became increasingly unpopular, especially in the big cities, repealing the law was eagerly anticipated. Later, President Franklin Roosevelt signed an amendment to the Volstead Act known as the Cullen-Harrison Act, allowing the manufacture and sale of beer and light wines. Thus, the initiative was a great failure as the citizens of the country did not support the move. For them, enjoyment and freedom was more important than anything else. The million-dollar question is, why did the prohibition did not work in the United States? Prophet Muhammad was the greatest change maker the world has ever witnessed, who got in change for the good of mankind, which ultimately made the lives of people easier.